Mickey, and our coverage of the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard. The ladies' short program underway, and here is the two-time and reigning European champion, 26-year-old Mария Butyrskaya, perhaps the stiffest threat to Michelle Kwan's attempt to win her third world championship.
Well, she looks beautiful and mature on the ice, but there's a coldness about her presentation, and that, combined with her history of nerves, is what has held her back in the past. And she is opening with a triple lutz, double toe combination. Nice.
Right there you can see exactly what the problems of her athletic ability are. She has a rather stiff-kneed landing, and it kind of is almost like a stalky kind of quality. She lands on a back inside edge. It's not a smooth, graceful, soft landing. Triple loop, but that was neat and very clean.
Wonderful extension on this.
That first position really was quite first rate.
Mária, up until her loss a few weeks ago at the Grand Prix final, was enjoying the best season and a half in her career. Two other Grand Prix wins.
You see the ice on the ice that marked the low eight curve from an inside to an outside edge.
Well, she has most of the difficult elements out of the way now. I think she wants to show that her mature interpretation sets her apart from all the younger field of skaters.
This next element, a spiral sequence. Remember how she does it and then compare it with Michelle Kwan's later. Best of positions.
Oh, she can be very proud of herself. She skated very well.
She made no mistakes, no major errors. And of course, that's the purpose of the short program. It's there to demonstrate your ability to do eight elements. And woe be to the skater that misses any one of them.
A much better effort for Mária Butyrskaya than she had in the qualifying round. She's told us throughout the year, she believes she can win a world title.
And here is her opening triple lutz double toe. She went in very cautiously, not a whole lot of spring, and a little problem on the landing, a little shaky, not a whole lot of speed. And this was her beautiful triple loop, taking off from that back outside edge. It just was floating up in the air, came down very solid, very pretty jump.
The first set of marks now for Mária Butyrskaya, 5.6 to 5.8 for required elements. The six-time Russian national champion trying to win her first world title. Not many thought she had a chance, but she told us all year she thought she could beat Michelle Kwan, 5.8, 5.9, and she is in first place right now. Inside Hartwall Arena now for more of our coverage of the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard. This ladies' free skate continues with the final group taking the ice. And Dick, it includes the leader, the six-time Russian champion, Mária Butyrskaya.
Well, the thing to look for with her is her nerves. That will tell you whether she will be able to do the six triples that she's planned. If she does those, then she's well on her way. And While you're at it, watch the jump landings to see if they're smoother and softer. And finally, her spin positions are great.
The year Michelle Kwan was born, Maria Butyrskaya was starting her fourth year in the Soviet figure skating system, a system which nearly destroyed her career. Her struggle began on the first day of school in Moscow.
I started figure skating by pure chance because next door to our house there was a kindergarten, probably unique in Moscow, with a skating rink. My mother would take me there. I was four.
The kindergarten coach spotted Maria's talent right away. She became part of the vast Soviet figure skating system and won several early competitions. But when her teacher left the school, Maria received little individual attention. She lost interest in a sport which treated her like a small cog in a colossal machine. When her spirit waned, that machine tried to spit her out.
They said I had no future, that I would never be any good. So they just expelled me. I was on the verge of giving up figure skating forever. I felt hurt that somebody decided my life for me, and I did not want to give it all up. So I decided to prove they were wrong.
Butyrskaya finally found a coach of her own and began her climb. She's won a Russian record 6 national titles and back-to-back European championships in 98 and 99. But she's a contradiction. Guarded, yet she posed for Playboy. She loves the Bolshoi Ballet as much as disco dancing. At age 26, she wants to improve on last year's bronze and win a world championship. But she knows that in 10 meetings with Kwan, Michelle has beaten her every time.
How do you look now to the world championship and Michelle Kwan?
You know, this is a difficult question because I would like will be a world champion. Mm-hmm. But Michelle Kwan, problem for me, but I will try.
Despite the daunting presence of 18-year-old Kwan, Maria, 8 years her senior, refuses to believe she's too old to achieve her dreams.
I have proven to myself and others that physical age does not matter at all in sports. When on the ice, I don't feel like a 15-year-old girl, but like a real woman. I'm glad that I'm old.
It'll be a testament to her perseverance if she can win the gold medal. Here are the current standings. Soldanova of Russia, Malinina, and Guzmaroli now in third place from France. But here is Maria Butyrskaya, trying to become the first Russian lady ever to win this title and the oldest skater ever to win a world championship in the ladies' competition.
So the question only will be, what is her nerves position? Where will she be on these triple jumps?
With Michelle in fourth place after the short program, this is a golden opportunity for Maria. It's either now or never.
The first move, this triple Lutz jump. Beauty, a beauty, and a very nice landing edge, very controlled. Must get this next triple flip jump out of the way. Camel positions, really a very beautiful forward camel position. She changes to a back.
Just the free skate, very important. Malinina, the top free skate so far. Michelle Kwan needs someone to have a better free skate than Maria Butyrskaya. She'll be the last skater.
Nice triple toe.
Good one.
And right into triple toe loop. She looks totally focused. She's not reacting to the crowd at all. Just focusing down on the ice and herself.
Thank you.
program. She knows very well this is her last year's program. She's very familiar with this.
Triple loop, double toe loop. Maria trying to complete a Russian sweep of all four disciplines here at the World Championships. It's never been done before. Austria did it, but there was no ice dancing back in 1925.
Triple toe, double sal.
How wonderfully done that was. It almost looked as though she was stepping out of it, but instead she went right into the next move, and it was a combination. Perfectly done. It's a crack in the stiffness of the face.
Beautiful position there with her arms behind her.
This audience is going to erupt for her.
And there is finally a smile on her face.
She knew she had 4 minutes that she may never get back again in her career, and she took advantage.
You know, the important thing for her is really less that she wins, that she was able to withstand the pressure, that she was able to give one of the best performances of her life, that she did not miss on those triple jumps, and that she, all that experience came to the fore. That is the nice thing that she will remember.
What do you think those Russians who gave up on her years ago are thinking right now? Maria Butyrskaya, with her performance here in the free skate, met the moment.
And this is her triple toe that she did. Good lift and jumping right up into a double salchow. Really solid.
Years of hard work, perseverance. That's what it ends up being, the emotion at the end.
5-8, 5-8, 5-7, 5-7, 5-8.
Remember, if Maria wins the free skate, then there's only one skater left that can help Michelle Kwan, the first set of marks.
Well, they're very high, and they're very strong. And,
you know, I think the Russian Federation of 10 years ago should be eating its hat right now after having dumped her from the team, removed her from the World Championship.
She had a skate of her life. She landed 7 triple jumps.
Thank you.
Oh, that's nice to see.
Well, that changed in 4 minutes here in Helsinki. Knowing that she controlled her destiny, Maria dramatically and emotionally finished the job, silencing her critics who said she would always succumb to the pressure. Not this time.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Lady World Champion for 1999, Maria Butyrskaya.
Within a few years, we've seen the youngest champion in history in Tara Lipinski, and now the oldest ladies world champion ever, Maria Butyrskaya, and the first one to ever do it and represent Russia.
You know, all this talk about her being the oldest at 26, that's pretty young.
Not exactly over the hill.
Oh, brother.
And it's so nice to see her smiling. Usually she is so intense.
The music, Forever Tango.
Thank you.
simple double one. Or miss it a little bit. Listen, after you've just competed in the World Championship, you have every right to make a mistake. The events of the week of the World Championships are long and exhausting. Three full-out performances for each lady is an incredible amount of pressure.
And she was under intense pressure, and she came through.
Well, we saw her life change dramatically here in Helsinki.
Oh, we certainly did. And with all the tough times that are going on in her country, it's so nice to see her come home with a gold medal. That brings some joy.
She'll always be able to say on the most important night of her career, she was able to meet the moment. She was a lovely, lovely performance. So as